You gotta have 4 or 5 haters.
Hey, do you?
And if you don't,
do you consider yourself a one hit wonder?
Yeah.
He say yeah. He say shit.
I better be known as a one hit wonder than not a hit at all.
Like a bummer.
I feel like.
You know what I'm saying? Even though I made some other songs that's pretty good and stuff, you know, just ain't meet what that did. You know what I'm saying? Like on my second album, when I came back from signing with Universal and I got a prison, they told me, I tried to get them to start putting out, you know, little literature about me while I was locked up.
Yeah.
Little Troy, big baller shot called Walk the Walk, Talk the Talk, fresh off lock. You know what I'm saying? Let's get that started.
Yeah.
I've been in prison. Let's get it started. Universal wanted to wait till I come home. So when I come home, they say, well, we need to hear the music you're doing. Nope. Y'all didn't hear my music when I first put my album out. Y'all picked it up because I'm the A&R. They say, we need to get to the A&R people, let them hear. I say, I'm the A&R. I don't need your people to tell me what songs they like.
Yeah,
I know what my people like.
Yeah, especially
I'm doing
out
this
here.
Here.
Yeah.
So they say, well, we can't give you a release date until we see the song. I sent them an album cover with the release date on it and everything. This is my album. This is what I'm finna put out.
Yeah.
Well, we need to hear the music. I said, nope. Because if I send y'all any music, it belongs to y'all in y'all library. So I ain't sending y'all shit till y'all give me a release date. Well, we can't give you a release date. Well, release me.
And that's what happened.
So they like, well, we'll release you, Troy. We don't want to see you go. Release me. So they released me. 2 days later, I called them back. Hey, where that check at? They say, what check? That pay or play check. That $150 y'all supposed to send me if y'all don't put my album out. Send that check.
Ooh.
They looked. They got a phone, called me back about an hour later. Oh, Troy, we saw we'll have your check. We're going to overnight tonight.
Really?
They had to send me a check for $150 because I put it in the contract, pay or play. If y'all decide that y'all don't want to put this album out, y'all got to still pay my royalties and all this shit on the album. You know what I'm saying?
On the Wanna Be a Baller. On
the whole album.
On the album. The
whole album.
That's what I'm talking about, that album that had that.
They still got to pay me
$150
for
on the next album that didn't get released.
Yeah, they $150 up front. They got to send me that. If you don't put my next album out, you send me $150. Pay or play.
Oh yeah, that's
yeah.
So you released Back to Ballin' independent.
Back to Ballin', I turned around and went to Koch Records in New York.
Okay.
Right? And so I went and got me a better deal. I got me a 60-40 deal. So I'm getting 60%. They getting 40 now. So I'm finna really clean up now. I ain't gonna gotta go platinum to make some money.
Just to make some bread.
Yeah, I'm finna get paid now.
You sell 300,000-400,000 copies.
You get what? Yeah. I already had the houses, 2 Mercedes Benzes. 2 rap vans, a Navigator, I had all the jewelry I want, big old house, everything. So now I got this deal with Koch. They gave me $275 up front, you know what I'm saying, just to come do the distribution deal with them.
That's on top of that $150 that Koch just had sent you.
Yeah.
The next night. Yeah.
All right, so I'm straight. I ain't worried about no money. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm still getting paid from Universal. But then when I go to Koch Records, and the morning that my album get ready to come out, I got to do radio. Mr. Dave called me, hey, man, you ready to do radio? Yeah, man. He said, I got a lot of places lined up for you to start doing your radio. So we sitting there talking on the phone. Next thing he say, oh, shit, this fool. Look at this fool. This fool ran into one of the towers, man. This motherfucker must have been fucked up crazy or something. He talking about somebody ran into the towers. I'm on the phone with him. So, you know, we still talking. He not thinking nothing about it. By that time I turned TV on, they got it on the news now.
Yeah.
Showing the way he hit the first tower. Next thing you know, I see the second plane hit the tower. He on the phone with me. He's stationed in Manhattan. Troy, I gotta go, man. There's another plane, bye. He hang up the phone. I don't talk to him for like 5-6 months. I don't know if he got killed or nothing at first.
He'll do from Koch.
Koch. Mr. Day, he's in Manhattan. And that's what happened.
That
was signing
story.
Them.
Yeah.
But it just tripped me out that I seen the plane hit with my own eyes.
While I'm
on the phone.
Damn,
and I'm getting my album coming out the same day. Right now, my album coming out.
So that fucked everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
That, man, it messed me all the way up.
Yeah. So you was on the phone when that motherfucker hit.
The second plane hit.
With somebody in
Manhattan. Set up. He do radio, so he had to set up for me to do all these, you know, call-ins, all these stations, you know what I'm saying? So we was getting ready to do that. That killed everything, man.
Yeah, man.
That's some wild
fuck
shit.
My money all the way up. I ain't get no more money from that or Universal for about 5 years. Four or 5 years. I ain't get no money from them no more. Because we didn't know put the album out. Universal record, everybody music went down. You know, they weren't playing number talking on the radio every day for years, damn near over a year or two.
Yeah.
They weren't playing no new music. They were not adding no new music. And everything went down for years, man, for me. It went down so bad that I fell off a cliff. And just started going back and couldn't stop. Just going back, can't stop. Just hit until I hit the dirt. When I hit the ground, I went underneath the dirt.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? Here it is, I got all these calls, this big old ass house. I can't make no money. I'm not going back to hustling. Wasn't no shows going on at the time. No money coming in. I'm like, wow, get the fuck out of here.
Gotta adapt to something.
So I say, well, I'ma just go back to one of my old houses. I got a couple houses still that, you know, it ain't this, but hey, y'all pack up. We finna move back to one of the other houses.
Yeah.
I went, took the Mercedes Benz, parked it on the lot. And they say, hey, you can't just park it on the lot like this. I said, I'm finna turn it in. I don't want it no more. I'm not paying y'all.
I don't want
the
it.
Note, the note.
Y'all can have it. I don't want it.
The note is paid. The note is paid right now. The next month, I'm not paying it. So y'all, whatever y'all gonna do, here y'all go.
Yeah.
I took the wrap off the van. We parked it at the lot. I don't want this one no more. Hey, there y'all go. They thought I was playing. Put my house up for sale. Made it look like that you never knew whether a black person or a white person lived in the house. When somebody came and looked in it, because you're not going to want to pay $550 for a house and you know a black person lived in it. White people ain't going to want to go buy a house behind a black person.
No,
black folks paying no $550,000 for no house, too. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I sold a house, but I had to pay it until somebody get it. Man, I was going in foreclosure. I'd come up and pay it right back, catch it up till somebody bought the motherfucker.
That's crazy.
When I tell you, I fell off. It was nothing I could do because that was my only stream of income. That's why they say I always have more than one stream of income come in.
Man.
I thought I'd set myself up. Money from Universal. Now I got money coming from Koch. And that was before Southwest Wholesale that went out of business. I was getting money from them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So all my stream of income just folded at one time. Southwest Wholesale.
Yeah, they folded.
They went under.
When they went out.
They went out. You know what I'm saying? So I was getting checks from them. I was going to get a check from Koch. I was getting checks from Universal. Everything just stopped.
Fucking 9/11, boy.
Boy, it fucked me up. And then now with this COVID,
this real similar.
I'm like, this happening all over again. I know I ain't finna lose all this shit now. You know what I'm saying?
Streaming numbers went way down during the lockdown.
Boy.
Niggas ain't just listening to me. Ain't nothing to celebrate.
Man.
Ain't nothing to.
But luckily that this song. It's still a classic, and they still owe me a bunch of money. It's in the kitty, so they still have to pay me. I think I'm going to be good through this one.
So the 5 years when they wasn't sending you a check, your scans were still counting.
Nobody wasn't buying no music at the end.
Oh, I dig it.
Nobody wasn't buying no music. They would send me a $3,500 check, $5,000 check, $7,500 check. I was used to getting a $100,000 check, $200,000 check like that. Now, all of a sudden, I'm getting $6,000 check. In a couple months. What am I doing with this?
Can't do a lot with that shit.
Yeah.
I dig it, man.
Shit.
Oh, okay. Well, then, I wanted to know.